Today, we are in conversation with a remarkable social entrepreneur, Mrs. Simeen Kaleem, who is the co-founder of Gramhal. Gramhal is an Indian non-profit organization that designs digital solutions to support better decision-making with agricultural communities. Since its inception, Gramhal has worked with more than 200,000 farmers to develop solutions that support farm livelihoods. Hello, Simeen. It is great to have you on board for this interview.
Thank you.
Let me ask you a first question. How did you get into social entrepreneurship and become a social entrepreneur? What was your journey? Why didn't you start just a regular job?
That's a very interesting question. I think in all honesty, I am a social entrepreneur by chance. I think when I got on this journey, I got on this journey after working in a regular job for about 5 years. So I took that route first, and then I realized that, you know, I've spent so much time working slightly away from communities. And I wanted to do something that empowers the community and work with them kind of at the first mile. And that is when I started Gramhal. When I started it, I just wanted to solve the problem of farming community about information and income. And I knew very little about what it entails to be a social entrepreneur. And in the 4 years of doing this, I think my definition of it has changed over time. But I just got lucky, really, and I stumbled upon it, and I'm learning as I'm going what social entrepreneurship is.
Excellent. Obviously, we are the World IP Organization, so we're quite interested in learning about new technologies, research and development, new ways of innovating or doing things. In your social enterprise, what types of innovations can you say have you brought to the fore?
I think a couple of innovations, really. I think one of the biggest innovations that we're trying to do is to how to bring real-time market intelligence to the farming community on their phones. For example, like in the real world that we are in, the way we get access to stock price information in real time. But farmers in India, when they're trying to sell their crops, when they're making those decisions about selling their crops, they don't have these kind of data. And that really affects their decision making. So one of the biggest innovation is how do we make the market intelligence that is real time and reliable accessible to these communities on their fingertips.
You use the word communities quite a lot. So one characteristic of a social enterprise seems to be this co-creation of stuff with the local community. So maybe the distance between the social enterprise and the community is even more narrow than a traditional company. Can you give examples for this, how you collaborate with the local community?
I think when we started out, we really struggled with how do you collaborate effectively and in a meaningful way with the community. And, you know, we also talk about a lot about design thinking in social enterprise. How do you bring communities to the forefront and the center of your solution? So after a lot of trial and error, as you rightly said, we built something that is called as Farmer Board, like a board that an organization has. We said that the community needs to be a part of our board. So we built a Farmer Board, which looks at our solutions, vet our solutions, and kind of gives us feedback all the time about what we're doing. And I think that we have about 12 farmers on that farmer board from across India. And I think that having that farmer board as the central pillar of the organization has been very, very fundamental for us, and has also been very effective in terms of to see how the solution gets adopted in the communities and how effective it is.
So you're really walking the talk in terms of involving your clients. Very interesting. Maybe to conclude, obviously there's a whole policy apparatus out there in the world to support business innovation, right? So we have innovation policy frameworks set up in all countries that are particularly targeted at promoting formal innovation of formal enterprises. But a similar framework doesn't really exist, to my knowledge, for social enterprise. So what are the challenges that you face? And do you have a particular wish list to policymakers on how to address them to? I'm sure a lot of them are listening, so please go ahead.
I think the first one definitely is how can policies support small enterprises that are doing impactful work to do impact at scale, right? You do not have to be a very old organization to drive impact at scale. And I think that is where policy interventions really come into place, where the government programs, especially in countries like India, that is huge, right? You cannot work without the support of the government. You cannot scale your work without the support of the government, or rather working with the government. So create those plug and play spaces, you know, in the government models where social entrepreneurs and innovators can come in and say, listen, you know, we can step in. This is our plug. Can we do this and see if it makes any change in the work that you are trying to do? To leave some of those areas kind of open for social innovators, for us to come and see if we can bring or make the system more effective. The second is, I think, when anyone builds social enterprise, you know, from day one, we think, what is our end game? Where is this going to end? You know, should it die with me? Should it just become this one huge social enterprise in 5 years, 10 years time? And I think that is where the governments in countries like India come into play. We are working with the central government of India in kind of strengthening the data pool for farming communities in India, which impacts 20 million farmers. And that's huge, right?
Huge.
If one organization can say that we have worked on information divide and we potentially know how to kind of solve for it, and here is what you can do, and the government accepts that and scales it to 20 million people.
Excellent. Yeah, those are good insights. I mean, a lot of this seems to be working already quite a lot for you, but you've also expressed a few areas where more could be done. Look, Simeen, this was great. Thank you very much for your time and for shedding light on your social enterprise, Gramhal. And I'm sure we're going to look up the examples and the positive impact that you have generated. So all the best to you and see you soon.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, everyone, for joining us for this discussion. I hope you have gained valuable insights into the power of social entrepreneurship in addressing dynamic challenges. See you soon.